So we covered the between operator, we covered the in operator, we covered the comparison operators, we covered the arithmetic operators, we covered the null operator, null and not null operator. Now the final one is the Boolean operator. So what is the Boolean operator? There are actually, how many? Okay, where is it? There are three Boolean operators that we have. One is an, or, and not. So I think not you have already seen, but and, or. These two are the Boolean operators which are used very frequently in almost all of the queries. What happens when you use and condition, and what happens when you use or condition? Not we have already seen, so I won't be talking about not, but let us talk about and. Okay, and operator. You have condition one. See, in where clause you always have conditions, right? If you see where, we have one condition, correct? And over here we have two conditions. In the where clause we have condition one and we have condition two. So when we use conditions, conditions can be true or false, correct? See, over here salary is greater than 1000 is a condition. So what happens when you specify a condition? A condition can be true, a salary can be greater than 1000, or it will be false, right? It will be less than 1000. So any condition that you specify, the output will be true or false, correct? It's very simple. So all the conditions work in the form of true or false. So with the and operator, let's take you have two conditions. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll actually pick up this sample for you. It's easy to understand. Okay, with the and operator, what happens to your output? You have condition one and condition two. Okay, so condition one is true and condition two is also true, then you will have the output, correct? So if both the conditions are true, then the record will be in the output. So if the salary is greater than 1000 and salary is less than 3000, then it will be in the output. Perfect. Now if the first condition is false and the second condition is true, what will happen? No output. Understand this, guys. There is an employee whose salary is 800. So the first condition is false, but 800 is definitely less than 3000, right? That's pretty much, I mean, maths, correct? So 800 is less than 1000. That means this condition is false in this case, but it is definitely less than 3000. So it's a true. So with the and operator, if you have one condition false, then the record will not appear in the output. The same goes if your first condition is true and second condition is false, then also you will have no output. That means the record will not come in the output. Both the conditions must be satisfied. So if there is an employee whose salary is 5000, that means salary is greater than 1000, perfect, the condition is true, and salary is less than 3000, no, it's false, it's greater than 3000. So if one condition is true and the other condition is false, the record will not be in the output. Okay, so that's how the and operator works. And definitely if both the conditions are false and false, you will by default will have no output. Now let us look at the OR operator. What happens with the OR operator? So with the OR operator, what happens is the condition changes. Let me take another example where department ID is equal to 10 or department underscore ID equal to 30. I'm taking some example. Perfect. Now with the OR operator, what happens? We have an employee whose department number is 10. Okay, so the first condition is true, or the second condition, definitely it will be false, because at any given point of time, in this case, department ID, we can only have one condition true, because there is only one department ID. So false, then the output will be given. Because any one condition, if it is satisfied, you will have the output. There is another employee whose department ID is 30. Then what will happen? The first condition becomes false, right? Or the second condition becomes true, you still have the output, right? And the third one is, let's take, I think if both the conditions are false, like if some employee's department ID is 50, both the conditions are false, then definitely you don't have an output, no output, right? In the same case, let us look at another example, this same above example with OR condition, and audit the statement, what happens. Now, if you are looking at this salary, so there is an employee, his salary is 800. Will there be output or not? So there will be an output, correct? And what if the salary is 8,000? So technically, guys, this command does not make any sense, because you will have output of all the records, right? Because both the conditions will give you all the records as the output, right? But I think you get the idea. So with the AND condition, or with the AND operator, all the conditions must satisfy in order to get the output. With OR operator, any one condition, if it satisfies, you get the output. I mean, if any one condition is true, you will get the output.